And those are the breakdowns that are frustrating for a coach. You're starting to make a push. You don't get a call on one end. That's that toughness, that resilience. You got to go down. You still have to play on the other end. And Paul George has an answer.
Paul George had an answer every single time, keeping him in the game. It's back to four. 11 of his 22 here in the fourth quarter. We still have 5 minutes to go. Maxey on Coffey. Back up top to Buddy Hield. Batum fumbled it, now releases it. Can't get it to fall. Powell the rebound.
Not a clean catch. That's a tough shot when it's a fumble.
And Harden will reset. Batum, a very versatile defender, now guarding Harden. Harden goes right at him. Layup blocked from behind. Batum got a piece of it. Here comes Harris the other way. Maxey on the drive. Puts it up. Shot no good, but a foul. And two more free throws from Maxey.
He's not an all-star. He's never made an all-star team. Hasn't won a title. But just plays great team basketball night in and night out.
So well with Joel Embiid because of his passing ability, his ability to stretch the floor.
Maxey with the free throws.
And so you think about the opportunity to potentially get Joel Embiid back for a playoff push.
Sixers are hoping, if you're just tuning in, nothing new, no updates, still no contact, but he's been doing drills and work on the court. Kawhi Leonard pulls up, shot is good, one-handed, those enormous hands from Kawhi Leonard. That's only his fifth field goal, he's 5-for-17.
One of the few possessions he's had one-on-one coverage.
A three-point game with 4 minutes to play, such an important game for both of these teams. On the drive, kicks it out, Hield for three. Batum knocks it loose, ball still alive. Norman Powell stolen by Hield, inside to Oubre. Oubre throws it up and puts it down. Buddy Hield's hustle and Oubre converts, it's back to five.
Multiple levels of effort, that's a heartbreaker if you're the Clippers. They played excellent defense, could not come up with the hustle plays. The 50-50 balls.
And Batum just got over-aggressive. George sold it very well, but there was certainly contact there. Norman Powell gets free, goes inside, left-handed layup. Just his third field goal, but an important one. It's back to three. Sixers' largest lead in the game, 15. Here in the fourth quarter, they're up by as many as nine. Tobias Harris on the bounce, finds Buddy Hield. Hield jumper, got it. Buddy Hield, big buckets in the second half off the bench. Hield 6 of 10 from the field, he's got 14. Harden hearing the boos again, he's heard them most of the night in his first game back since the trade in November. 7 on the 24. Norman Powell fires away. It's good. Powell, a big three-pointer. And a two-point game with 2.5 remaining.
Norman Powell, instant offense. I mean, he's a guy you got to find every time. Close out, run him off the line.
Clippers, one of the best road teams in the NBA, trying to have a big come-from-behind win. Harden with the strip of Batum and the steal. Paul George, three-pointer. And Hield grants a rebound as we approach 2 minutes remaining.
And we're going to see the Clippers continue to shrink the floor for Maxey right here. He is going to see multiple white jerseys. 2 minutes. Force him to give it up.
Buddy Hield has got Harden on him. Drives on James Harden. Batum, corner three. It's good! Nick Batum, a huge three-pointer. And the lead back up to five. Leonard kicks it out. Harden up top to Powell. Powell the bounce, the drive, left-handed, banks it home. Back and forth they go, a three-point game. Under 2 minutes remaining. Maxey is facing the double team. Hield is open. Hield drives, pulls back, 7 on the 24. Maxey hoists up a three. George grabs the rebound.
Maxey's going to continue to see that double team. When you get out of it, you got to attack. And there's Paul George attacking.
Batum played him well. George thought there was some contact once again. Powell is shadowing Maxey as he walks up the floor. Harris looking to drive on George. George staying in front of him. And Nick Nurse sees a bad possession developing, calls timeout. Here in the fourth quarter, Sixers trying to hold on. They lead by three. Maxey falls down. Coffey gets it. Goes up. This is the jam, but a foul. Not a bad foul there from Oubre. Maxey slipped, tripped, and lost the ball.
9% free throw shooter this year. Hasn't taken many, but he's 48 of 54. Knocks that one down.
Just lost his balance. Norman Powell right there. Going to be on top of Tyrese Maxey.
Where they are double teaming and ball deflected. That looked like it may have been off Oubre.
It did look like that.
And they're going to challenge it. Paul George immediately looked off. He deflected it, and there's a good chance that's Clipper ball. All right, they made a decision. Let's hear from Kevin Scott.
After review, the call on the floor has been overturned. The challenge is successful.
Wow.
It's clear and conclusive by the replay center that the ball goes off Oubre's right hand out of bounds.
Into the hands of Paul George. Under a minute to go. Two-point game. George finds Coffey. Coffey tied up to Kawhi Leonard. Layups. Bounce it in, and the foul. Leonard took a hit. Little English off the glass. And the game is tied. A chance for the Clippers to take the lead.
But what a play by Coffey. He didn't have the shot. The collapse on the defense. Terrific play and recognition and awareness by Kawhi Leonard to make that 45 cut. And what a finish.
A struggle offensively tonight. Just 6 of 18. But what a huge bucket. Only 13 points. And now a critical free throw. Leonard's a great free throw shooter. 44 seconds remain. Nails that, and the Clippers regain the lead. It's their first lead of the fourth quarter. The Sixers have led almost the entire game.
And you're going to show bodies to Maxey. You're going to force him to get rid of the basketball, play in the gaps.
Maxey looks. Buddy Hield has it. Hield thought about launching a three. Maxey gets it back. 7 on the 24. Maxey to Batum. Up top to Hield. Hield puts up a three. Bang! Buddy Hield from way downtown. And the Sixers back up by two. What a performance off the bench for Hield. 15 points here in the second half. The Sixers, an answer every time. 22.7 remaining. They're up. And a two-point lead for the Sixers. Each team still has a timeout remaining. Philadelphia, no fouls to give. Shot clock is turned off. 22.7 remaining. Harden, George, Leonard, Powell, and Coffey out there for the Clippers. Harden looking into the hands of Leonard. Kicks it out. Coffey back up top. Leonard takes the three. Drives inside. Lamb counted and a foul. Leonard, another chance for a three-point play. The lane was wide open, and using his offhand, banked it home.
Well, this is just terrific spacing, one-on-one. Great extra pass by Coffey. Nick Nurse told us about Kawhi Leonard. He knows when it's go time, and it has been go time the last two possessions.
Leonard knocks down the free throw. One-point lead for the Clippers. Nick Nurse does have a timeout, deciding right now not to use it. Maxey drives, double team, and a whistle and a foul. And they had a foul to give. It's going to be a side out, not in the act of shooting. With 7.9 remaining.
After review, the call on the floor stands. The challenge is unsuccessful. Defender commits illegal contact with his left arm to the offensive player. Another reviewable matter is whether the shooter was in his continuous shooting motion. He was not at the time of the illegal contact. So the game clock will be reset to 8.8, and Los Angeles will be charged a timeout.
Here, almost everybody on their feet. Batum looks to inbound, looking, finds Oubre. Oubre off the bounce, drives inside, goes for the layup, and a wedgie. It's stuck in there. It'll be a jump ball with 5.1 remaining. Clippers up by one, 5.1 remaining. Leonard wins it. Batum tips it back to Hield. Hield throws it across on the drive inside. Oubre blocked. And no whistle. Game is over. What a tough finish for Philadelphia.